This may be the most important story most Americans missed last week. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell changed a rule that could mean more presidential appointees getting through Congress much faster. John Avalon here with a reality check. John.
Morning, guys. Look, life is a struggle between the urgent and the important. We live in a time when reckless rhetoric and outright lies can sometimes obscure really important decisions that'll shape your future. We saw that a few days ago when Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell went nuclear, and it barely registered on the Richter scale. McConnell invoked the so-called nuclear option to push through Trump nominees along narrow partisan lines at a faster clip than ever before. In the words of columnist Dana Milbank, McConnell, quote, undid 213 years of history in 33 minutes. Now, the self-proclaimed Senate institutionalist cut debate on lower court and executive nominees from 30 hours to only 2. And it's not as if they needed the speed. Republicans have pushed through a record 36 Trump circuit court judges in Trump's first 2 years. And that's compared to 19 for Clinton, 17 for Bush, and 17 for Obama. Trump judges are overwhelmingly white, male, and young, and for what it's worth, a high number of them have been rated not qualified by the American Bar Association. But McConnell and company argued they needed to make such a move. They pushed out these stats showing the outside number of cloture votes required on Trump nominees. But here's a critical bit of missing context. Even more cloture votes, 150, were required on Obama's nominees from 2013 through 14. A period of unprecedented obstruction against Obama by the GOP, and it was then that Harry Reid implemented the so-called nuclear option to go simple majority on judicial nominees, excluding the Supreme Court. Now, furious McConnell warned that there'd be hell to pay.
Say to my friends on the other side of the aisle, you'll regret this, and you may regret it a lot sooner than you think.
Of course, McConnell got his revenge on Reid by blocking Obama's Supreme Court nominee Merrick Garland and pushing through two Trump Supreme Court nominees by simple majorities. Now McConnell's expanding his strategy to lower-level appointments, angrily accusing Chuck Schumer of this.
He started this whole thing.
He started this whole thing. Talk about sandbox politics, people. And now the same scorched earth strategy is going to be applied to everything from assistant secretary positions to lower court judges and Federal Reserve positions, to which Trump just nominated this guy.
My 999 plan. 999.
But there's a deeper cost. As a wise man once wrote, quote, the key thing about the U.S. Senate is that more than any other institution in any democracy, its rules are designed to safeguard the rights of the minority party. Invoking the nuclear option created a precedent that allows a simple majority that gets impatient to change the rules at any time to achieve a totally partisan agenda. And that, he warned, would undermine the Senate's unique role as a moderating influence and put a permanent end to bipartisanship. That would be Mitch McConnell, circa 2016, in his memoir, The Long Game. And that's your reality check.
John, it is so helpful to see how we got here and to hear the hypocrisy built in there.
Yeah, Mitch McConnell's long game is a different game here, I think, it's safe to say at this point.
Very different.
Thanks, John.
Thanks, John. The